What's up? What's up? This is day 209, Making Songbringer, and today I'm working on this for the next 2 weeks. This is going to be kind of I'm going to be refining, polishing the game, and getting it ready for this next release. There's an advanced alpha release coming out this month, so 2 weeks I've got to polish this up and make this game more playable, more fun, incorporating all the elements that have been added and all these new features since the last version, the last release, which was in early July. So yeah, about 2.5 months of development, kind of boiling that down, polishing it up. That's what the goal is. So I've had something on my mind for quite some time, and I would love to be able to for this to succeed. Is that Mars of Power? What? Buongiorno! What's up, man? I would love it if I could get the frame buffer size and the window size to be independent of each other. So right now, you can see that the shadows in the game. Actually, I'll take a screenshot, and that should clarify what I'm talking about here. All right, Azenris, Arcane, Canada, Arctic Raj, what's up, y'all? Yo, yo. So if I set my window size to tiny, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Ahodge. Did I say it right? Ahodge? That's cool. I've been to Prague. I love Prague. Oh, it's so cool. And I've been to Lake Bolaton. I went to a festival in the hills near Lake Bolaton. So awesome. I love the Czech Republic. Okay, anyways, yeah, so I'm gonna run it in a tiny mode. Hold on, we gotta save this screenshot. So here's the screenshot, big. This is a big window. Oh, it's like ahoy. Okay. Ahoy. Cool, that's what we say when we're pirates. All right, so here's the window with, this is a small window, small frame size. So the problem with Coco City X, or at least I haven't found a solution for this yet, but that's today's goal, is to get it. So I want, check this out. Look at these shadows. What's up, Barkor? All right, ahoy, ahoy, ahoy. So these shadows are really beautiful because this is the 420 by 240 window. This is a very small window, actually. But look at this. When I do a bigger window, I get this sort of blurry effect because it's actually 8 times the pixels in there. Hey, what's up, Jonah19? So that's today's goal. I want to be able to draw a really big window, but with the pixels, with only 400 by 200 pixels. So that's what this is gonna do, is I'm gonna make this, the frame size, I've looked this up and I think this is possible. There's OpenGL has frame buffers, contexts, and windows. So I want the window size to be giant, the entire screen of whatever screen you're on. But I want the frame buffer to be really tiny. And so it renders the whole game to this really tiny window, and then it scales it up, but without doing any of this kind of nonsense. So that's today's goal. I believe it's possible. So you bear with me. This might be kind of a crazy day because I don't know. I'm not sure where I'm going here, how to do this, but I think it's possible. The first thing I'm going to try is the most obvious thing, and that is that Coco's 2DX has this set frame size function. I don't think this is going to work from what, because I looked at the code, what this does. This actually changes the window size. I don't want to change the window size. I just want to change the frame buffer size. So this is kind of a poorly named method here, but I think I'm going to try it anyway. So if we just set the window size like that, make sure the game is running itself at full screen. Yeah, I hope this works. I hope this works really, because this would be sweet. And it also will make the game blazingly, like, way the hell faster. So that'd be really cool. Oh, yeah, yeah. You do, man. Oh, there we go. Okay, so it did. It looks like it made a really small window. So it did just change the window size. That's not exactly what I wanted at all. So this method is not what we need. And I'm pretty sure that Cocoa Studio X has not implemented what I'm trying to do here. Yeah, that could work. Boxes? You got boxes or books or something you can put it on? Okay, so there's some things we can mess with, right? Inside the actual implementation of it all. Boils down into here. I'm just going to straight up edit Cocoa3DX's code today. I typically don't like to do this because I hate it when I upgrade Cocoa3DX and I have to go back and change the code that I already edited and stuff. So typically, I think it's a bad idea to manually edit libraries. But in this case, I just want to play with the library and see if I can get it working, and then if I need to, I can do a patch on this library that I can always, you know, redo later. But I might be able to discover a way through this to actually do this using Cocoa3DX's calls and stuff here. So we'll see. Nice, a paper towel roll. Cool. Yeah, it does. Cool, Azenris, that's nice. What are you working on right now, by the way, Azenris? What are you using GLFW for? No, I hope this works. So here, let's see. We call init with rect with a frame zoom factor. Let's go. What if I go back to my game and yeah, okay, so I'm creating it with the frame zoom factor of 1.0. And here's where I set the resolution policy too. Yes, yes. Yeah, totally, right? This is the beauty of open source, and also, you know, it's also kind of a drawback in the sense that you have to keep up editing it if you update your library, but it's just beautiful to be able to actually change it if you need to. Ah. All right, cool, man. So I want to check in. There's one more thing I need to look at before I can go straight up just editing the GL view. And that is this call to set design resolution size. So when I call set design resolution size, it's going to change the design resolution and the policy, but it's not going to change the screen size. And then it's going to go and update like all this other stuff here. Oh, right, yeah. I've had to do that too. I've done my share of web work. And I'm glad to be making games now. But just yesterday I had some web work I had to do for an old client. So all right, yeah, so it's setting the viewport. Ultimately, this sets the design resolution size. Wait, show all is what I'm using. And then it gets a viewport based on So it gets scale X and scale Y is your screen size over your design resolution size. That makes sense. What I really want to do is just set the frame buffer to be this design resolution size and set the window to be the actual screen size. Right? Let's set a breakpoint right there. Let's run this. I'm trying to change this the way the OpenGL window creates. Oh, I'd love to get your feedback on this actually. What I'm trying to change is this. I want my window size to be the same, right? I want the window to fill the entire screen. But I don't want to do this. See how the way Cocos 2DX works is that you set your window size, and that also changes your frame buffer size for your GLFW window to be the same size. So this is creating these kind of blurry shadows, and everything is rendered at 2560 by like 8 1600 or whatever it is on my Mac's Retina display. But I want it to look like this. I want it to simply just be 400 by 200 pixels, old school Nintendo-like pixels, but then scale that up to my screen size. So basically, small frame buffer, big window. That's my goal for today. And I think this is possible with GLFW. But I think it's just the way Cocos 2DX is setting up GLFW's window. Right, here we are. This is being called from KittyNet good as I expected. So we've already created this GLFW window. Wait, actually, let's verify that. Set two breakpoints. One breakpoint should be here. What's up, Alex Pita? It's going to be a pretty much code day today. Buongiorno. Right, good. So that I just verified that. It is definitely creating the window first, and then later setting a breakpoint where it is setting it's kind of like resetting up the window by setting its design resolution size. Viewport, set rect. Let's check out what these variables are. After that, this. Mamma mia! It's a me, Mario. Nice one, Boogie. Right, here we go. Viewport width 1280, height 730. That would be. What's the viewport rect? Where's that at? Here we go. Design resolution size. That's what I want. That's what I want the frame buffer to turn out being that big. Yes, Coin54. Yep. You get your Steam code. So if you pre-order, you're gonna get a Steam code. It depends on the level you pre-order at. If you're just pre-ordering the $16 version of the game, you're gonna get your Steam code when it finally releases in like January to February. If you pre-order at like the $32 level, you're gonna get it a few months earlier. If you pre-order at the $64 level, you get it this month. So, I hope I answered that well for you. Yes! Haha! It's a me! Yeah, here. So the screen size is 1280 by 800. And I want that's what I want. I want the screen size to be that big, but I want the frame buffer to be this size. Let's see what the viewport rect got set to. Okay. 1280 by 731. That's great. That's what we want there. Right now I'm using just the policy where I would do black borders. Eventually I'd like to improve that, but for now, this game is pretty hard-coded for a widescreen resolution. What's up, Fearless Hyena? Salute. Yeah, of course. Yeah, it doesn't matter what size your screen is. It'll scale up to be as big as it can on that screen. Oh yeah. It's me, Mario. All right. So the scale X is three, scale Y is three. Wonder what this does here. It's close to 16 by 9. Yeah. What's banded? Set alpha blending, set depth test. Yeah, this always looks fine. So that didn't actually change the window at all. Yeah. Right. What we need are some breakpoints inside the actual implementation of GLFW in here. So here's init with rect. We'll set a breakpoint there. This is really important. This one here is like does a lot of the work. Update frame size. This is probably another important one here. Lateral bands, yeah. Oh, okay. Banded. Yeah, I get you. Yeah, black screen, black. Blackness if it's, yeah. Letterbox, exactly. That's, I think that's the USA way to say it too. No, I'll actually email you Coin54 so you can choose whatever name you want. So if you look like all these backers, right, have already submitted all their names and stuff. Where's my backers text? There it is. So yeah, these people, like some of them chose to use their own name. Some of them chose to use other stuff too. Like here's Alex Pita right there. There's Mars of Power right here. These guys were some of the very first backers of the project. But yeah, look at this one. This somebody put in memory of Dave, President of Mars, died while fighting the Hulk at sea. You know, you can put whatever you want. Update frame size. This one I'm gonna need to set a breakpoint. Where is that? Here we go. Update frame size. Ah, see? Set frame buffer. This is really important right here. This might be the way to actually do it. Set viewport. Oh, this might be it. Viewport? No. Yeah. Yeah. Here's just more of like input stuff. So this is oh, here we go. This is important. On frame buffer size. So basically, I'm setting breakpoints in all of this code here to kind of figure out how it works. 'Cause I have no idea what gets called first, how this all interacts. Oh, this is Windows code. All right, I think we're ready to try this. Okay, so the first call we get is a knit with rect. And that creates the window. Okay, now we've got update frame size, which is being called from, init with rect as well. Okay, so this calls its own set frame size method, and then calls update frame size, updates frame. So we're still within the very first initial call to create with rect. Oh, I don't want this breakpoint anymore. Oh, yeah, I love you guys. What's this one? Oh, we don't need this one anymore either. Well, yeah, I guess we might as well leave that. There. Okay, just... Oh, and then we get the on frame buffer size called from... from my own hide title bar. Yeah, so I got some stuff which modifies the window size. What's up, Mike? You can. Nice one. Oh, right? Yeah. I know. I've heard of one called, it's called Razor or Raptor or something like that. You've probably, if you've explored on Linux for a good DAW, you've probably seen it already. So let's see what happens now. Right, that guy, D'Artagnan. Frame size width, frame size height. What do we got? It's the existing factor X, factor Y. Ah, okay, so it's not even setting the window size here. Yeah, Linux is great. No manual entry. What command is that? What's up, Vlad? Oh, okay, this isn't even modifying anything. It's just, what's this one again? And there, it's finally running. Okay. Cookies day, huh? Yeah, BSD is pretty nice. Well, I mean, Mac OS X is great. I love it. I love the fact that I've got a Unix backend. What's up, Unreal? It's going good, man. I'm working on some code today to try and get the frame buffer size for my OpenGL to be really small, and then the window size to be really big. So it basically renders everything to a tiny, tiny buffer, and then scales it up. So it'll be able to look, the shadows I want to look like this instead of how they do look now, which is like this. So the goal is to get the print, get it to be true pixel art like that. Oh, it's actually pronounced Vlad. Oh man, you haven't told me. Thanks for letting me know. Hey man, sorry, I wish I knew how to what you're saying here. There you go. Vlad. What's up, Vlad? Yes, it is. Yep. What's up, GNZ? BSD is Unix. It's like Linux, basically. But it's a Unix operating system. Unix-based. Right? Oh. Thanks, Azenris. Let's see. Yeah. I think I've got to actually use GLFW's code, though. Yes, it does. Really? Oh, in the game? Will it have robbery? I don't know. Elves and stuff? Maybe. Alright, Jonah19. See you, man. Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm good. Elves. Vegetable ears, huh? Alright, let's try something radical. Let's just modify directly. I'm just going to hard code what the window size and the frame buffer size should be. All right, here's where it creates the window. And then afterwards, let's call GLFW, is it set? I had this researched a second ago. I think this is it here. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks, man. Oh. Yeah, totally. What's up, Brunsbear? Yes. Enum help? Oh. So it's saying that to immediately try create the frame buffer by creating my window really small and then calling set window size after that. Or just call this in the frame buffer size callback. Let's try that. If I were to call GL viewport in this other, where is this breakpoint at? On GL frame buffer size. Let's call GL viewport. Let's do this. I hope this works. 420 by 240. That's my res. Let's turn off that. How am I going to port it to Windows? I use a cross-platform game engine called Cocos 2DX. It's already ported. It's already done. Jeff Fame. Yeah, thanks, Coin54. Yes, I will email you and get in touch with you on what name you want put in there. So, yep. Yes. What's up, Gigaroid? I love it, man. Let's see what happens. We've got GL viewport being called. Did that work? No, I don't think that worked. Let's try that again. It means I'm hungry? Yeah. All right, let me try it one more time, and I'll get the player down to where he's standing up. Yeah, that's not working. Okay, well, next thing, next try. Yeah. Really? What's up, Brother Bear? Hello. Let's try this other method. Instead of doing GL viewport afterwards, let's do it so it just hard codes how big the window should be by using init with rect. There. See what happens. Because later on it's going to try and set the frame size. I don't know if that worked either. Damn. Maybe it's might be modifying it later. Yeah. How did I learn? I'm self-taught. Yeah, I learned from books. All from books. This was 20 years ago, so we didn't have YouTube and Code Academy and all the great resources you have today. So all I had was books. But it worked. Nice. Yes, yeah, he's got a mustache. Jib has a mustache right now. He's actually got an item called the Jib Stash. So this is the Jib Stash, and it gives Jib a mustache, and it's going to be a rare item that you find. And it might actually improve Jib a little bit. I wonder what would happen if this was actually 210 by 120. It's a mouse stash? What are books? Yeah, I think it's still not working. What are PDF? Are you sure they're made of bits? So, where is this? Here we go. Set frames. Yeah, that is the frame buffer size callback. So, we definitely need a breakpoint here and here and here and here. You should pull out some tea and crumpets. Yeah, that's a good thing to check, right? It does seem like nothing has changed. It should be, right? That's why I'm going to set some breakpoints to make sure this is actually going. Yes, totally. All of these. A cigar. I like that. A hat and a monocle. Yeah, well, I know it's not working yet, so let's see what happens when I run it again with these breakpoints in. No. No, I definitely love using breakpoints these days. I used to use printfs all the time though, especially as a newer programmer. That's all I would use is just, hey there, see, look at that. It's initially creating the window with the right size. Well, actually that window is twice as big as it needs to be. So let's go back to two. This should actually be 210. This is it. This must be in points, or at least for this monitor. Right? 40 hours to compile? Good lord. I didn't see this window. There. Okay, that's the tiny window. I want to see that. Just like that. And I want to make sure it's never getting to the point where it actually changes this. Oh, there. This is the call to set window size. That might be messing it up. It's calling update frame size. See if it's calling, getting called anywhere else. I don't think I need that one anymore. Okay, so there. That's why it's not working, because it's actually calling, changing the window size there. You asking me? Yeah, I got Retina. Wow. Whoa. Dang. Java 1.4. That's before that was a while ago, right? What's it, where are we at now? Look at some of these variables that it's getting set right here. Retina factor. Retina factor is 2. Okay. Oh, it's Java 8? Oh, wow. Screen size. Over 2 times retina factor times frame zoom factor, which is 1. So this is going to be 1 times 2 times half the width. So this is going to be the screen width. Oh, check this out. It's already got the frame buffer size for us right here, so we can compare that. Yeah, okay, the frame buffer is right. Let's see if we add a GLFW call to viewport. Isn't this what it's called? Yeah, oh, just GL viewport. It isn't. Should be. Yeah, I think it is for me. Is it wrong on here or something? Don't know. That's weird. This is tricky. Yeah, nice. I'm gonna try something else just crazy here. What if I undo all my changes? And I go back to the game and actually create the whole window and everything. Four twenty by 240. Okay, cool. We're creating the window really small. Window's still small. Oh, okay, so never called my frame rec thing. Or did it? There you go. You can code purely in hex. Why do you even need hex if you've got binary? There, now we're hiding the title bar, which should reset the window size. Okay, so I can comment that out. Let's see if this works. Wait, is there really a language called white space? No way, there really is. Oh my God, it's so great. Oh wow. Whoa. No way, that's awesome. Yeah, I've seen that one. Arnold C, what's that? It's Morse code. Yes, like it's basically Morse code for programmers. Arnold Schwarzenegger based C programming language? Oh. Oh. False as I lied. Oh, this is good too. Knock knock is and. There you go. Do it now. Do it now. Oh my God, it's so great. Oh yeah, it's so good. LOL code? No way. Dude, this is so great. Hi, Ken has standard IO. Okay, thanks, bye. Oh my God, this one's so great. Please open file. Awesome, thanks. Oh noes. Oh man. Just reading this is so hilarious. Oh man. I know, right? This is one I would actually want to use. It's so funny. Where are we at here? What the hell is that doing? Oh yeah, I re-enabled that, did this. Oh, okay, so it made the window really, really small. I wonder why I did that. Let's see. Yeah, rewrite Songbringer in LOL. Chuck Norris Basic. Heck yeah, I like metal. Yeah. Whoa. How non-geeks think it works. Yes. Wow. Right? Might be able to, I can watch this later. I don't want to get. Cool. Yes. Yeah. Oh, right on. I can't wait to see that. Malbolge, I've heard of this one. Oh yeah, this is the one that's so crazy. Malbolge. After an instruction is executed, the value will be replaced with itself mod 94. Wow. This is like the most crazy programming language ever. Wow. Arctic Garage, yes, of course. Of course. Yeah, in fact, I just downloaded Kogos 2DX 3.8 today. And I also Xcode. Oh, look, I'm still downloading Xcode while I'm streaming. I hope that's not messing anything up. But yeah, I got Kogos 2DX. I need to play with it. The new 3.8. Sucks, because they were supposed to be fixing the whole auto-batching with. And they didn't fix that yet, so that's the one thing I was looking for. I was like, I hope they fix the auto batching. Yeah, it doesn't take time, and it did not end up muted. It didn't even get flagged. So somehow YouTube missed that one. Yeah, that's pretty cool, right? Nice. Huh. Cool. This like a series? Hell yeah, I definitely need some good cartoons to watch. Nice, Mars of Power, yay! Right, man, if you're going to bed, a good night. All right, so if this. Oh, what's going on? Why didn't that work? Really? Oh, that's nice. What's up, Mr. Tim? Okay, this is kind of weird because it skipped over some of my code. We're supposed to set the window size. Make a porn game, huh? You want me to make a porn game? Alright, so what's the rect coming out to be? Origin size. Oh. Yeah, I'm doing good, man. I'm trying to make my goal for today is to make the window size the same thing. I want the window to cover the whole screen, but I want the back buffer, the actual frame buffer, what it gets rendered to be tiny. So essentially it'll make the shadows look like this, like true pixel art, versus what they look like right now, which is sort of this blurry blend between pixel art and this. So that's the goal for today. I want it everything in the game to be actually rendered as small buffer and then scaled up to whatever screen size it's currently running on. And I don't know if I'm close or what I'm doing here. I have no, I really don't know what I'm doing with this. So I hope this actually works. Ah, well, here's the problem. The frame is not the screen. So I need to be setting this to screen size, actually. See what happens now. What software do I use? I'm using Xcode to make my code. I'm using Photoshop for all my art. And I'm using Ableton for music. All right, there. So now we do have a frame buffer that's tiny, and we have a window that's big, but we don't have the right effects going on. Really, I wanted to scale that up, so the frame buffer gets scaled to be as big as the window. So maybe this isn't even possible, I don't know. Huh, well, let's try that again. I'm gonna try and pay a little more attention to that second time it calls that it gets called, or it gets that callback after the code that manually sets the window size again. Now set the GL viewport after that? Okay, I might try that, yeah. Yeah, exactly, in the callback. Right, yeah, it's really hard to read down there, but scale it up. What's up, Spymort? Sean is crazy. What's up? Yeah, yo, are you still crazy? All right, here is the callback we're getting. I believe, wait. Oh, yeah, that was the one. Okay. Hmm. Nice. All right, let's do this again. See, I think it either needs to set the. What do we got here now? Factors tiny. Frame size, really tiny. But W. Ah, see, yeah, it's actually getting the frame buffer size callback. Oh, wait a minute. So we're getting into this method though, and this actually looks like it's setting the frame buffer size really big after I do that resize of the window. Oh man, this might be like this complexity of this all these different calls and updates to the window size might be slowing it all down here. I might need to simplify all this. What's Steve Lee? Yeah, the name of this game is Songbringer. Sorry, I'm kind of in this state where I can't really show you the game because I've modified so much of the code here. But hopefully I can get it to the point where I can get this fixed and I can show you the game. No, DirectX is only for Windows. Yeah. So I think what's happening is because the window gets resized, it's actually changing the frame buffer size too, from what I can tell. Because this on GL frame buffer size. The size of window is measured in screen coordinates. OpenGL works in pixels. The size you pass into GL viewport, for example, should be in pixels. On some machines, screen coordinates and pixels are the same. There's a second set of functions to retrieve the size in pixels of the frame buffer of a window, right? If you wish to be notified when the frame buffer of a window is resized, set a size callback. So we're getting this callback. Yeah, so that it is. It's actually changed. It doesn't matter that I went and changed. I created this window with a certain frame buffer size. It actually is getting changed when I change the size of the window, because this width and height right here. Yeah, this width and height. Is W and H, and W and H is 2560 by 1600. That's the whole size of the whole screen. Huh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, totally, right? Writing your own game engine is a smart thing. I'm kind of confused right now because of this, but. You know, I get a lot of the benefits of using CocoaStudio X though. Right? Yeah. It does take a long time to write it yourself. A lot longer than it takes me to just go and figure out how to modify stuff like this. Okay, so we've established that the frame buffer size. Is really big. even though, yeah, so if anything, let's just try this geo viewport. Let's set this back to really small thing. Let's turn off breakpoints and see what happens. What's up, King Nothing? Yeah, maybe that is, maybe that, this, yeah, let's check that out actually. So the goal for today, King Nothing, is to do this. Like, this is what the game looks like right now, the shadows in the game, right? Here's a player, here's some shadows. It renders these blurred shadows at my screen res, which is 2560 by 1600. So it's like, this is why you get so many pixels here. And this is not a true pixel art. I want it to be true pixel art so the shadows would actually look like this, right? So they're actually pixels. So that's the goal. I want to render all the game in a tiny, tiny frame buffer and then have that frame buffer scaled up to the window size. Yeah, this shadow's pretty cool, right? Okay, yeah, I'll look into that set viewport, but let's see what happens if I run it like this without any breakpoints. I mean, I already technically tried this before. Yeah, it still did that thing where it's just in the bottom corner. What's up, Grim Gary? Welcome to the stream, man. Working on trying to get a tiny frame buffer with a big window. So I would call director set viewport. Does that even work? This doesn't even take any parameters. But let's see what it does. If OpenGL view, which is the class I was working on there a second ago, set viewport in points. Yeah, I could, right? I could just modify my shader. But what I really want to do though is be able to have the game run way more efficiently, right? Because right now, it's rendering all this stuff at 2560 by 1600, and it causes my game to slow down when I'm streaming, right? Because this Open Broadcaster, it actually eats up quite a bit of CPU and GPU. So I would prefer if the game rendered everything to the smallest possible buffer and then just scaled it up rather than having to do all the work of, updating a million pixels versus a couple thousand pixels or whatever. It'll just get the game to run faster on every platform, you know? This would be so sweet if I get this to work. Really? Thank you. Iyer Koken? I hope I said your name right. Right? Yeah, that's a good thing to try. You know what? You might be correct here. Do you have any examples of that or any links? Me just write down your thought here. I was thinking about that earlier, but I was pretty much I came to the conclusion that this wouldn't be efficient, but it might be the only way to do it. Yeah. That's an interesting one, right? What would happen if this was that way? Yeah, I'm familiar with this. Thank you for your suggestion here. What's up, Pete and Wally? Okay, without changing anything else, I'm gonna go back to where it sets the frame buffer size and try this just to see what the hell is happening, right? Let's see if this actually even works. Why use a Mac? Because no spyware, no very little viruses. You got a Unix back end. Unix is so awesome. Yeah, thanks, man. See, you proved it. If I set my, I can't. That doesn't even work. Calling this whole GL viewport down here doesn't do anything. So let's see what happens if I do. Let's not call. Here in kit services, I'm just going to return from this method. So I'm basically disabling that. In the game, we want to create it with 420 by 240. Actually, no. Wait. Let's create it with the original rect size. And then after we've created the view, let's call view set viewport in points. Yeah, exactly. Right, this is a good way to put it. You got Bash and Photoshop. That's all I want to develop games. Ableton. Man, I hope this works. I'm not even going to set a breakpoint. Let's just see what happens. No, I'm working on yeah, I'm working on getting the whole game to render to a smaller buffer. Yeah, it's not working either. Wait, what if we do it after we even call kit init? Oh, I get it now. You're saying it's a full screen map with a tiny little mini game called Songbringer. So hard to tell, but I think it's still not working. So set viewport in points. It might be that I just need to change all these variables. What's up, Nano? So this basically just calls camera set default viewport. What's up, Sunset Kai? Welcome to the stream. Well, see if I can get the if I can get it to actually render, yeah. Here, okay, here's the experimental viewport. Default viewport, what is all this stuff? This is a class called camera. I haven't seen this one before. Get depth. Here's a frame buffer object. Oh, experimental frame buffer? Interesting. Which will attach several render target for the rendered result. Now we're starting to get to some stuff that might be what we need to be looking for. Set viewport, for example. Camera set viewport. It's not a static method though. So you need to get the camera. Camera. This might be it. This might be the way. The Cocos 2DX way. This is actually calling GL. You see, it looks like you can even set your own frame buffer object. Yeah, Pete and Wally, that's what Iacocan was saying up here. But I prefer not to do that because I'd rather use Cocos 2DX's render just the way it is. I don't want to change my whole game. I don't want to change I don't want to try and change the way Cocos 2DX works. I just want to change its frame buffer size. I want the frame buffer to be tiny, the window to be big, and for it to scale that up. It's already rendering everything to the frame buffer. It's just the fact that I think the frame buffer is always getting set to be really big. Yeah, okay. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna set I'm gonna undo everything. Everything so far. Whoops, not this stuff. Right, and 6 months later, okay, I'm gonna delete all my breakpoints up in here, so we should be back to pretty pristine state. Right, yeah. It's reverse stream. Okay, cool. I haven't changed anything in that bit of the code. All right, I'm gonna go focus on this whole camera thing now. Where did that go? Camera. Here it is. One more. All right, so when it applies, let's set some breakpoints in some of this. To see if this is even being used, I want to know if this is. If this actually is something that's being. It's actively used, or if this is something experimental. Because maybe this is what is keeps on changing GL's viewport. Oh, it looks like we are getting this called. So this is coming from scene render. The first time it renders the scene, okay? Okay, so there, it looks like the scene has multiple cameras, or it was possible for the scene to have multiple cameras. So apply frame buffer object. Let's see if we have one. Yeah, so there's no frame buffer object being applied to the camera. So it's like maybe I need to create one of these frame buffer objects here. Okay, let's pay attention to this. When it initializes a frame buffer, and see where that's being called from. Okay, so it's actually first updating the camera. Oh, it's never calling init for those frame buffers. Oh, wait. It's calling that every frame. Okay. Is it actually calling this every frame? Yeah, it's calling that too. Wow, so every single frame it calls GL viewport right here. Oh, no wonder the okay, so no wonder the calls to GL viewport weren't working because it's doing this. Its viewport size has already been set. Wow. Okay. So let's try this. Let's try setting the default viewport in game. After it's done and initialized everything, let's create a viewport object. And let's get the so camera get default viewport. Does that compile? Looking like this is fine. Yeah, it's a static const experimental. Okay, that's fine. So let's get the viewport, and then we'll set it to be something else. So I'll set a breakpoint here after it's gotten that. And we'll see what we should be setting the viewport size to be. Okay, VP, left 0, bottom width is 2560, height's 1462. All right, let's try it. VP.size. Doesn't look like it's working yet. Yeah, possibly. But see, I know if I change that, Maybe. Let's see if that works. See, and I'm not sure. Let's check one more thing before I do that. I want to make sure if this is even, if it's overwriting itself, right? So every time it calls CC cameras apply viewport, I basically just want to re-enable breakpoints just to see if it's actually using that default, that viewport I just set. Yeah, okay, it's right there. Oh, see? Look, it got set back somehow. Something else overwrote. It's probably that I'm using this whole all these systems in the wrong way. I'm trying to hack this in, but I have a feeling there's a way I can this is possible to do this. And I might not even have to modify Cocos 2DX. Well, I guess I would just set a breakpoint here where it's setting the default viewport. And it's not hitting that breakpoint. I know, there probably is, yeah. It's probably my bad for not exploring this enough before I started streaming today. Let's actually just do that really quick. No, that's not true. No. Static variables don't mean that they don't change. That's a const. Yeah. Static just means that it's part of, it's a static variable. Man, Coco, right? Oh, no worries. What's up, DCZilla? Yeah, I know it's a crazy code day for me today. Sorry, I'm really not showing the game and stuff today. See, this guy's got multiple frame buffer objects. Yeah, totally. Yeah, I know. Eventually I'll figure this out. I bet you by tomorrow I'll have this working, and then the game will be like looking better. Yeah. Yeah, and then it comes back really quickly, you know? Just like riding a bike. See, check this guy out. He's actually using frame buffer objects. So, here, let's save this link. Hopefully I can. How long have I been already in streaming? Let's see, 20 more minutes. If I can get this done in 20 more minutes, celebration time. Frame buffer. Yeah, I've already got that. It's I checked that out too. It is total, it's relevant, but I'm not sure. It's what it does is it changes the window size, not the frame size. Yeah, totally. If this were directly to OpenGL, but the names for things in Cocoa City X are a little bit different, but I think this actual frame buffer class, this thing, is the same thing as OpenGL. But when you go to their windows, the frame is not actually the frame buffer, so it's kind of confusing. DCZella, so here's what I'm trying to do. So the goal for today is this is what the shadows look like right now. Right in the game, so you can see they're really, really—they're not that good looking to me, in my opinion. But you know, it's all a matter of aesthetic. But this is what I want them to look like. I want it to be purely pixels, right? This is the game running at 400 by 200 pixels. This is the game running at 2500 pixels by 1800 pixels. So I want the game to be a pure, truly pixel game and actually render everything in a tiny frame buffer and then scale that up to whatever your screen size is. So it'll be way more efficient. Yeah, it's true. Right here it is using the default. I'm wondering though if I can just change the default FBO, right? If I go in here to apply default FBO, I was looking at this a second ago, and basically this method here does actually use a frame buffer. So I'm thinking that if I can just change the default frame buffer to be the right size, then maybe this will work. Yeah, true, true. Let's go to the Cocoa Studio X forums. Yeah, I think I've seen this before, but maybe they've updated it. Yeah, see, I've already got my design res set and everything according to a really small size, but it's not changing the frame buffer size. Pretty sure. Yeah. Oh, this is kind of an old post. No, it's not. So they might have actually done this recently. Yeah, I could always mess with the shader, but the problem with messing with the shader, I could totally get this to look like that with the shader, but then it's still going to be rendering, you know, millions of pixels for nothing. So I'd prefer if it was only rendering a couple thousand pixels. This is a tiny, tiny window compared to that one, and it'll be way more efficient and fast for the game and for GPUs. Every save a GPU, right? So they're using it a little bit differently as a render target. Yeah, am I actually calling that? I don't think I am. Oh, there I am. Yes, I am calling that. What is that getting set to? It's being set to 1. So it's effectively shouldn't be doing anything there. Yeah, I started with that. Yeah, I've already tried making a really small window like that. And then it just came out to be a small window as expected. So, I want to set a big window, a small frame buffer. And there's all this code in Cocos 2DX right now. At least this I'm with version 3.7 and there's all this code which let me show you. It actually sets the viewport size every single time it renders. And so I was doing all this code to try and modify the GL viewport size. And then it wasn't working. We were like, wow, it's not working. And then we found out that basically it's in here. It's calling apply viewport every single tick. So it's overriding anything I would have set for the GL viewport size. Man, I guess I could do this. Let's rewrite this function. I'm gonna go ahead and throw this into camera. So I can set a breakpoint here. And find out who the heck is modifying this. How do I calculate pixel size? I leave it at 1. I don't even calculate that. Yeah, it's just 1. Totally, just it's always 1. See, now it has to recompile all of Cocos 2DX. All right. Well, at least we'll be able to figure out this now that this is recompiling. Like I said, there's a breakpoint here, and All right, so here's some code to test out the camera frame buffer object. Huh. Okay, let's try that. I'm almost done compiling. Don't think I've actually tried this yet. Yeah, and that would be the best solution, right? The simplest thing possible. All right, so here we go. Set GL default values. Set projection, set viewport, set viewport, set default viewport. Ah. Right. Yeah, this might be the way to do it, right? That's that might be the way that has to be done. Totally. What up, professional novice? Working on kind of some tricky stuff here to try and get basically I want the shadows to not look like this, and I want the shadows to look like this in the game to render a lot faster. It's ready? Okay, I only got like, I think, let's see.
Yeah, it's okay. You need to cool down too.
Five more minutes, so.
Yeah, take your time.
All right, 5 more minutes. Let's see if this works. Let's try this solution from Lunar Melt. This is actually a really good one. But I do want to see if what was going on here with the set view default viewport, right? There, it calls it again from Kidinit. And here I'm calling it again. And here's where it gets called again from render texture begin. Wow, I never knew this would be called here. Exact fit. Yeah, essentially, it'll speed up the rendering of everything. Yeah, right. Okay, yeah, let's try some of these solutions. I can always go. Wait, where is this being called? Again, area create. So when I create a render texture and I begin it, it goes and it overwrites the default viewport. So hold on. If I were to go, yeah, that's okay. I'm just gonna try this. I'm gonna try these other simpler solutions first. So yeah, I think Azenris and Lunar Melt were suggesting the same thing essentially, right? Either call set frame zoom factor. So let's try this with exact fit. Turn off breakpoints. Yeah, so okay, you're saying if I do a small window. So wait, what's exact fit supposed to do again? Yeah, I don't know. Guess we can just leave that alone for now. So if I create the window or the view with the small window size. Right, this should create a small window on the screen. All right, but we want it to be even smaller. So this is must be in points. So 210, 120. And then we're gonna grade, okay, once we've created the view, we call set frame zoom factor. Let's see if we just set that to 2.0. This would be so cool if this works. This simple way to do it. Oh, nice. It does look like it. So I would need to update my tech, my shaders to work with this, right? Huh. You know what? This might be it. So frame zoom factor is gonna be So let's create the window with R2. Wait a minute, isn't create with rect the frame zoom factor? Oh yeah, so if I did 2.0 right there. Yeah, I know, right? If this works. But I don't know if this is I don't know, I'm not sure if this is actually working yet, because let's find out. Let's just find out by doing a quick fix of not even messing with the math, but actually going 25, 60 over 420. This should be 6.09. Right? Because I know what's going on with the shader. The shader is actually working with frame size and stuff, and I would need to just update my shaders to work with this whole new situation. But okay, now we've got a bigger window, but how can I tell? Oh, wait, so the shadows are still working. It's just that my other shader is not working. So let's see. Let's see if this actually is rendering pixely shadows. Oh man, I don't think it is. Yeah, it's not working. These are tiny. These are yeah. Damn. See what I'm saying? I think. Well, it looks like might have to try the whole frame buffer thing then to keep going. Yeah, there you go, right? It looks all pro like I'll probably have to do another 2 to 3 or 4 hours left to get this to work, but I know. Hopefully I have something to show you guys tomorrow, 'cause I'm totally out of energy, and my girl, she got dinner done, so we're gonna have some dinner now. But so yeah, anyways, I will definitely let you guys know tomorrow what I find out tonight. I'll keep working on this, 'cause this is, I don't know, this would be so cool, right? I think it what's your name again? Koken. I heard Koken. This trying I might try this technique, right? I'm gonna keep exploring the whole frame buffer object route and the whole viewport route and see if I can get those to be working. I might actually have to do this whole technique right here. So, create a frame buffer object that it renders to, and then scale up that frame buffer rend object. So, yeah, I think that's what I was doing though. Okay, let me. On. Thought I was already doing this. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this set frame size method I already called. Yeah, I already did it this way. So essentially what hap what Asnerus with Cocos 2DX, this create with rect is the same thing as calling set frame size, and then set design resolution size I already did down here to the small size, and I was also using exact fit. So I basically did try that already, but I wish it worked. So yeah. Yes. Thanks, you guys. Yeah, I'll be back tomorrow. I'll have something to show you guys about how this all turned out. Nice. Netherlands. All right, you guys. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. We'll be back tomorrow, same time, usually 2 to 4 p.m. Pacific I start. So yeah. Thanks again for all your help today, and I think I'll have this figured out by tonight. We'll